In this video, I'm going to try to show you the quickest and most efficient way to make a pie chart, a frequency table and a pie chart if you have a really large set of data. And what I'm going to use to do this is the teen maze data, and I'm going to do it for item Q1. So the first thing I need to do is make some room for the frequency table. So I'm going to click on the column and right click and insert to insert another column, and I'm going to do that twice. Then in column F here, beside my data, I'm going to make the numbers that we're going to count, so 1 through 5. So we have to tell it what we're trying to count, and then we're going to use the command to do it. We're going to type equals to tell it we're doing a math formula, and then frequency. And then you have to tell it where the data is located. You can type in the cell numbers, but I like to click and drag. This can take a while if you have a really big set of data. We have about 300 something here in the teen maze. Okay, and then I'm going to click comma, and then I'm going over to the side, going to scroll back up, and then select the bin arrays, which are the numbers that it's going to count. And close that up and hit enter, and it counted all of the ones. To get the rest of them, what I have to do is click on that cell, drag it, and select all five of the cells, and then hit F2 to select everything, and then Control Shift Enter. So that was F2 followed by Control Shift Enter. And there's the frequency table. Apparently Q1 there were 5 students that responded with a 1, 16 that responded with a 2, and so on. And then to make the pie chart, I just select those entries, click on insert, click on the pie chart picture, and there you go. I can change the label or delete it. I can click on the pie chart, right click, and tell it to add labels. I can click on those labels, right click, and tell it to format the labels, and then I'm going to go over and tell it to show percents. So there's my pie chart that counts the outputs. Yeah, it looks like 33% responded with a 5, 27% with a 4, and so on. So that's how you can use Excel pretty quickly to make a frequency table and a pie chart.